and welcome. You're watching Head to Head. I'm Antonina Antosha with UATV. The Cabinet of Ministers of Ukraine registered a draft law on general secondary education. It provides practical mechanisms and tools for developing the new Ukrainian school and aims to build up a quality environment for pupils, teachers, parents, and educational managers. To discuss this draft law, we're joined in the studio today by Nataliya Shulga. She's a senior expert on education and science at Reanimation Package of Reforms. Hello, and thank you for joining us.
Hello.
So in 2017, if I'm not mistaken, the Parliament passed the law on education. And according to this law, on September 1st, 2018,
Reform had been started,
but the pupils were supposed to be entering the new generation Ukrainian school. How's that going?
Well, so far, the first year was very successful. Mm-hmm. Almost 100% of money allocated to create the new environment for elementary school happened. Mm-hmm. So these kids came to the new school because it was new for them. It was not the setting which their parents used to when they studied at school. So it was more mobile environment, more playful,
more
free.
What were the main differences between the school their parents had to go to and the first graders went to in 2018?
Because first 2 years of new Ukrainian school, elementary school, it's more based on play. Mm-hmm. So kids are learning through playing. It's a very nice transition from mm-hmm. preschool or home education to school. So they do not feel more changes, more restrictions. Mm-hmm. They feel more comfortable. When I was asking parents whose children entered the first grade, they all were surprised. They said, you know, children really want to run to school. They love it. They mm-hmm. don't want to stay home. That's the first indication that reform started successfully.
Mm-hmm. Moving on, there have been some novelties, as we have discussed, introduced, and they are grouped, shaped according to the groups they are aimed at. So those are pupils, teachers, educational managers. Let's talk about the novelties that are proposed to the pupils.
At elementary school? Because every level has their own novelties.
Yeah. At all the school years, okay. Starting first grade and finishing at 12th grade.
The new Ukrainian school actually built a new idea that children should be in the center of the education. So it's a children-centered educational mm-hmm. methodology. This is pretty different. Before it was more school discipline methodology. Mm-hmm. So everybody should learn the same thing, the same curriculum, the same programs, very little fluctuations or flexibilities. Now it's completely different. So we are talking about the personalized learning path. What it means? It means that you still have a state standard for education. So every child should learn certain things at a certain level. But what is novelty is the way they are learning is different now.
How different?
More freedom for the teacher, because before it was just one textbook and children receive these textbooks and they work with the one textbook. Now it might be no textbook at all. It might be a teacher who supplied the material, instructional material, because the level of the teachers might be different. We're talking now in a perspective that higher levels of the teachers would be even to PhD level mm-hmm. at the even at elementary school, definitely at the middle school and definitely high school.
Well, are we talking here about state schools? Because as far as
right,
I know,
right, absolutely, yes,
even
it is.
Even if it's if it's a state school, according to the law, it should be following the program given out by the Ministry of Education.
And basic program, it's like, you know, if you don't have a PhD and you are not really a person who would be learning professional journals every month and stuff like that, you still have a basic program to follow. But But if you have a PhD and you have a research background, you might provide for your kids much mm-hmm. better
okay.
ways of learning. And
okay.
it's allowed now.
Okay.
Before it was not allowed. Now it's allowed even more. If some teacher, and we adopted a lot of methodology from private school, like Montessori for elementary mm-hmm. school, for example, they show the higher results, much better results by all definitions, not only psychological state of the kids, how they feel comfortable at school, the level of their knowledge they can demonstrate, the competencies, the new word which nobody really understand quite a bit, but it will come. So it means competencies. Why do you need to know math? This question was not asked before. It just
That's
you have
the question
to study
I get
math.
Asked by my 5-year-old every day.
Right.
Why do I need to learn math?
Exactly. And then the teacher or you, if you have some pedagogical approach, you will say, you know, do you understand that I'm planning our family budget for 6 months ahead? That means that I will be working to earn this money to pay for your clothes, for your food, for your entertainment. It doesn't come just by, you know, it doesn't grow on the trees. I have to earn it. So let's try to plan this budget together and then give your child a portion. And then the child would realize, no, I don't really understand how to do that. Could you help me, mom? Or can you help me, teacher? This way, the kids learn math as the life skill necessary for their future life and today's life. And actually, the competences, it's ability to use your knowledge in a real day life and making decision and be responsible for this decision. That's the whole idea through the whole 12-year education, which should be present at every level, every year, and every class. It's a different approach to learning process, not just learning for the sake of learning, but learning for the sake of successful life.
Okay, in the new Ukrainian school, how many kids are there in one class?
It depends, because in the different cities and villages, as we know now.
Let's take Kyiv, for example. Let's take the capital.
Well, the standard says that it should not be less than 5 per class and not more than 30.
How is it possible to create an each an individual pupil-oriented educational society and environment if there are 30 of them in one class?
It's possible because teacher can observe how the pupil progress in their learning.
Because we all know that kids, all
yes.
of the kids are different in their development
right.
and
right.
some of them, you know.
So for the first 4 years, the teachers are responsible to bring kids to pretty much the same level.
Mm-hmm.
When kids come to the school, it's a different than family, right?
Of course.
And they learn how to socialize, how to interact with each other, how to interact with teachers and the school as a whole, the new environment for them. During these 4 years, actually, teacher can see this kid already came reading and writing.
Mm-hmm.
Though this kid would not be doing the same task, will not solve
meaning the kid
same.
Would get bored while the others
no.
studying.
No. Those kids are going to the group and teacher give them more advanced
mm-hmm.
task to solve.
Okay.
And would be paying more attention to those who need to be brought to that level.
Mm-hmm.
And through different tasks and then communication between those subgroups inside of
the same
class.
Level.
Yeah, the whole idea, we observed actually how it worked in Scandinavian countries. Of course, Finland is unbelievable what they do.
It's way beyond for us right now.
Well, it's not like way beyond, but imagine that the whole education is for free, no, because it's in the 20th advanced economies in the world. They can afford, and their taxes not like ours, 15-17%. Personal income taxes, but 40-50. The people think it's free. It's not free. It means it's already paid by your taxes, but you need to have a good economy to subsidize such a high level of education. But imagine they select teachers 1 out of 100. So 1 to 10 to bachelor degree, they do not allow teacher less than master's come to the kids,
mm-hmm.
and 1 in 10 to the master's. So only 1 in 100 are certified as a teacher. And quarter of them at regular community schools are PhD level. So that's the teachers who are loving kids, loving their profession, loving what they're doing in class. And they're passionate about bringing the kids to the same high level. So that's why they look, is this kid is more motivated, more advanced, it would be getting more tasks to solve. They never would be bored. Plus, in every school, they have ability to send the kid, for example, to an orchestra. The kid will be playing some instrument. So if he already made what he needs to do in the class, he's going to play his instrument in mm-hmm. a class nearby. So they don't have that, you know, system like in Soviet Union that you attach to this class, to this group of people, and you work with them okay. for 10 years. So they're more flexible. And that's working beautifully.
Let's talk a little bit about the individual study program mm-hmm. that is possible to create for every individual student or pupil. And the school, the teacher, or the teachers.
And parents, of course. It's a triad now.
And the
it's
parents
only like
are
three components.
Collaborating or cooperating on right. this matter. How is
exactly.
this going to work?
Well, exactly. I am against this, gifted children or kind of special children by gifts. No, it's not working like that. Actually, it's a motivation. It's a motivation of the child to achieve some result. And if this motivation is present and cultured inside of the family and also at school, this child can progress to some profession, even at the grade of fifth grade or sixth grade. As early as better, because you can concentrate and you can advance through the path. But most of the children are not like that. They kind of, you know, thinking, changing their dreams.
Because they're children.
They're married. They want to play. They want to be entertained, and they entertain their classmates too. So they might change it. So the school should. And teachers, together with the parents, should realize, if this child really want to be a professor of physics, or maybe this child is so involved in constructing, maybe it would be good engineer. This child is obsessed with, you know, building something on the streets, on the roads. Maybe it would be the good worker and good supervisor of some construction place. So every child mm-hmm. might have a different attitude to different subjects. So it's not like you choose in the first grade that my child's supposed to be genius, math professor, whatever. It might change. But in higher school, the 10th to 12th grade, after ninth grade, actually, 15 years old, adolescent should be able to choose. Am I going to professional school and getting the first profession at 12th grade? Or I'm going to academic path and I'm going to be engineer or teacher or professor of math or whatever. That would be made at 15. And at this age, it should be personality, which telling the kids, parents and teacher, I want to do this. I want to progress in this direction. That's the whole idea behind the new Ukrainian school. Not some sort of, I don't know how to call it, kids at 15 years old. You know, and in the world at 16, you can get a driver license. You can really choose going to college or whatever. And our children living with parents have no idea what they want to do with them. You know, when we realize that we actually lost the whole generation of young people because they don't know what to do.
Several of them, I would say.
They don't know what to do with their lives, and it's not right. It's not right.
Okay, your personal pieces of advice on how to motivate a child properly to get good education.
You can see it. You can just observe your child, what is so attractive to the child, and create the environment that children can try different things, different sports, and you will see what kind of sport your child is liking. Mm-hmm. Soccer or swimming or running or jumping or whatever, or figure skating. Just provide this opportunity as soon as possible, at 5, 6, 7 years of age, and you will see how your child react to that. Provide the opportunity to learn arts, music, painting, knitting, whatever it is, you know, embroidering, whatever. And you will see your child kind of, oh, I don't like it. No, I don't want to do that. Oh, my God, that's what I want to do. And find a good place, good teacher. It's extremely important because child reacts to personality of the mentor, of the teacher. That's why true. In this reform, we are working very closely with reform of teachers' education, because it should be a selection of the people who really love children and really want to dedicate their life to teaching, to provide this opportunity for the teachers, children at school. So it's the whole change society toward producing the happy children and happy citizens, after all, and citizens who can make decisions and be responsible for them.
That's the whole idea. This is a very noble aim. This is a very noble aim. Hopefully that the whole Ukraine, our whole society, is going to be successful in reaching it. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you for having me.
That was Nataliya Shulga. She's a senior expert on education and science at Reanimation Package of Reforms. Thank you so much for watching UATV. Stay tuned for more.